Hey y'all, welcome back.
It's Wednesday, so you know,
we're winging it.
Today's topic is RV slang. So stick with us. Okay, before we get started, I want to give a shout out to Susan. Thank you so much, Susan, for coming out to our meetup on Saturday at Toppers, and to everyone who came out and joined us for the seminars and the fun. Had a great time. Bill and Susan were some of the folks that came out, and Susan mentioned she would love to see us talk about some slang terminology that RVers use that may be a little bit different than you hear in most everyday life.
Yeah, we thought, what the heck? Let's just wing it on that.
So 10 minutes on the clock. Whoop, I'm on the wrong thing. 10 minutes on the clock. We're winging it.
Winging it.
Okay, so let's just get right into it.
Yeah.
All right, so how about, let's start with honey wagon.
Oh, wow. Now that was one that we didn't even know until we went to a big, huge rally. And when I mean big, kind of like an FMCA rally or like the Balloon Fiesta.
Oh, Albuquerque Balloon Fiesta. Bucket list item, by the way, if you haven't been there.
And there were thousands of RVs there, but there were no like sewer hookups at any of these. So you have to have what's called a honey wagon comes out and can empty your tanks for you. And at Balloon Fiesta, they would, where we stayed, they'd come out every 3 days and empty out our tanks. So that was really nice, our gray and black water tanks. And yeah, that helps you get some longevity. And I guess you really only see them at these big rallies, because other than that, I really doubt they're going side to side. Maybe on some BLM land, maybe.
Well, maybe during the big events.
Yeah, possibly so.
But basically, it's a roving dump station that comes to you.
Yeah.
So pretty convenient.
Pretty cool. Called a honey wagon.
So, okay, along that same topic, how about boondocking?
Yeah, this is something we did a lot of last summer. It's when you have no hookups. You know, and you're boondocking. So like in a lot of national parks, you're just like, we have a camp, we're at a campground right here, but we do have hookups. And that's another term too. Hookups mean you have, well, at least electricity, but usually electricity and water. And in this case, we don't have sewer, but there's a dump station down the way. We were talking about
boondocking.
So in a boondocking situation, you have none of that. So you're just self-sustained.
So you're going to be, when you're boondocking, you're going to be using the water in your fresh water tank for water. You're going to be using your batteries for electricity. If you've got a generator, that's a great way to recharge those batteries.
Or sometimes run your ACs if you need to.
And so it's also called dry camping. Is what a lot of folks will call it also. Rally, we kind of touched on that.
Rally is a conglomeration of a lot of RVs, normally an event that somebody puts on and where a lot of RVers get together. I mean, and a lot is relevant. I mean, sometimes a rally could just have four or five RVs.
Right. It's a gathering of RVers.
And they're fun too.
Yeah, might be five RVs, it might be, you know, 8,000 RVs. Just depends on the rally.
And we have enjoyed every rally we've been to.
Absolutely. Okay, for a completely different thing, how about a donut? And no, it is not the donut you're thinking.
Yeah, this is an interesting one. It's a rubber piece that fits down into that sewer hole. That sometimes that's how you have to attach your stinky slinky to. Which that's one, a stinky slinky, which is that your.
That was awfully sneaky.
That was all. Yeah, I snuck that one in. But that is to, you know, your sewer hose is also called the stinky slinky. But sometimes you need that donut, and some places actually require it. There are places.
It helps your sewer hose to make a really good
solid connection, airtight basically,
right, with the dump hole basically. It's a very technical term.
Yeah.
I never thought I'd be talking about dump holes, but here we are.
There she is.
Okay.
We're winging it.
Yeah, we are. How about a toad?
Yeah, I mean, a toad is what you're towing behind your motorized vehicle. So like a motorized RV. So for us, our toad is our Jeep, mm-hmm. our Jeep Wrangler. So, and there's a lot of different toads out there, but they'll also call this a dinghy.
Right.
Sometimes. So they'll, like when you come into a park, they'll say, you know, what's your toad? Or what is your toad? And you'll say, well, I'm towing a Jeep. Mm-hmm. So those are the dinghy, toad, mm-hmm. tow.
That's kind of
tow vehicle. Mm-hmm. That's what you'll hear.
Okay. Flat towing.
That's simple. That's what we do too. It's four wheels down. Or, you know, I guess if you're towing a big truck that's dually, that has multiple wheels, it can be more than four. But all wheels are on the ground. And you're using, when you're towing, those wheels are all rolling at the same time. They're on the pavement also.
You're not using a trailer for your car.
Yeah, and to me, that's the preferred way to do it, because when you go places, if you don't have a trailer, is an additional thing you have to deal with. Mm-hmm. So, and you have to have places to put it and deal with it. So I tell you what, if you can tow four wheels down, flat tow, I'd say that's the best way to go.
Yeah, a lot of the campgrounds that we go to, there's really not a lot of space to park a trailer.
Nope.
To get it out of the way.
You may have to pay extra money to park it.
Sometimes. So that's just what we prefer.
Yep.
Okay. How about shore power?
Yeah, well, shore power is anytime you're plugging in your RV into power.
Right.
You know, like a power pole. Yeah. And but it's often referred to as connecting to shore power. Sounds kind of funny. Sounds like you're on a boat.
Well, you know, a lot of these terms remind me of boats. Dinghy.
Maybe they started from them. They probably started from a boat, maybe.
Some people call the kitchen a galley, which is kind of boat-like.
Yeah, that's true. And I think they probably came from boat terms.
Mm-hmm. How about mooch docking? You've heard us talk about mooch docking before.
As you know, we stayed at Greg and Carolyn's place. That's staying at some friend's place. Or, you know, it doesn't have to be friends. It could actually be kind of like a Harvest Host situation. You're kind of mooch docking when you stay at a business that they allow you to stay in their parking lot for free.
Mm-hmm. It's also called driveway surfing.
Yeah.
Another term you might hear.
Driveway surfing, you're staying at a friend's house, mm-hmm. and you might be parking in the driveway. They call it driveway surfing.
Yeah. How about work camping?
Wow, that's a good one. And that one is one that, you know, if you're full-timing like we are, that a lot of people that full-time work camp. And so they go to like a state park or different parks and they do some labor and they get their site for free. And some even get their site for free and also get paid. So it's just a given situation. We saw both at the place we just came from. Mm-hmm. They had a lot of volunteers that were park host, and those park hosts all got a free site. And their park hosts there were work campers, but they were almost full-time. When I say full-time, they lived there 6 months to a year at a time, if not more. Mm-hmm. And then the gatekeepers there had been just regular park hosts.
Which is volunteers,
varied hours per week, but they moved up to gatekeepers at that park. So since they become gatekeepers, they also get a free site, plus they get paid.
Mm-hmm. And so there are all kinds of work camping opportunities out there, but it basically means that you're traveling in your RV and you are parking somewhere for a period of time, and in return for your site and sometimes other benefits like pay, you do some work for them. And it can be at parks, it can be at campgrounds, it can be at theme parks, can be in Amazon during the holidays. There are a wide variety of options.
It is, you know, right now is a different time. though. Mm-hmm. You know, she's bringing up a lot of things that don't exist right now. These theme parks and stuff like that probably don't exist right now. But you just, this is something that can get people sometimes to full-timing sooner than others that aren't retirement age. Mm-hmm. You know, and even a lot of work campers are retired as well. They're retired, but why not get free camping and be able to be in a beautiful setting like a campground?
Talk to people. And
yeah, you meet people all the
pumpkin
time.
Pumpkin patches is another thing. A lot of work campers do
pumpkin
patches.
Yeah, that's right. Yep.
So
The Beet Harvest Festival.
Oh, the Beet Harvest.
The Sugar Beet mm-hmm. Harvest.
Yeah, that's a big one.
That's a big one. You got to Google that. It's pretty cool.
Okay, how about Blue Boy? We're returning to the potty topic here.
A Blue Boy is something we used to have. I'll tell you, we don't have it anymore because it took up a lot of room. And now we can go further with our tanks. The longer we do this, the
We've
better.
Learn more about tank management.
Learn more about our tank management.
Oh, yep. Goodness.
But the Blue Boy is the thing. It's a big container that you can dump your gray tank into. Some people do the black tank, but
we never did
the black tank.
We only used it for gray tank.
Gray tank. You dump the gray tank in. You can take it down to the dump station and dump it, so you don't have to, you know, unhook everything and go to the dump station and come back. So it's a time saver for some folks.
Mm-hmm. And they call it a Blue Boy because traditionally they were blue. Sometimes you'll see gray. They come in different colors now, but you can either. We used to connect it to the back of the Jeep and take it down real slow. We've showed that in some of our older videos.
Yeah.
Okay, we're out of time, but we are going to list more of these on our website, rvtexasyall.com. So if you enjoyed it, visit that. We'd also love to hear your ideas. What are some slang terms that you use as an RVer, or maybe some terms you've heard, but you don't really know what they mean? Leave us a comment and share, and we'd... love to have you join in the conversation. Until next time, y'all, safe travels
and happy camping.
Bye.